ain't even got this. Hey, buddy! What's up, nigga? You feeling me, man? It's like a motherfucking space station. Get the, you feeling me yet, man? The gold BBS is on this motherfucker. What's up, man? I'm taking for those men, man. Show you what you feel like. I ain't gotta go make me jump off. You think you the only one out here working, baby? Gotta make jump off too, baby. Come on, man, get in there. Let's take it over for an answer, man.
Hello, Jack. Let's go. Here we are for our very first session, daytime session in Paris with Low Jack. Hi, how you doing?
I'm pretty okay.
Pretty okay. And Tony Hawk for Big Life to come. He's behind, getting ready. And our friend Gab is here from London.
How you doing, mate? You're all right. Got to say, Tom Hawk's been, Luke's been very good with all the technical problems. Was it a duck and lamb's heart that you had last night? You're still suffering slightly from the adverse effects. Is that your fault?
Yeah. No, it's Swan's fault. Yeah, always.
Anyway, we're going to have a very different session today, aren't we? You're going to play 90 minutes of ambient records, I believe. Soundscapes?
Yeah, and a lot of percussions records and a lot of French music, actually.
Okay, and then Torn Hawk's going to be doing a very righteous audio-visual manipulation set, which is why we started slightly late, so sorry about that. But yeah, it's going to be... Can you call ambient music righteous? Oh, of course. Yeah, no, he's going to be wailing away on his guitar, and it's pretty cool. His whole setup's pretty awesome. Everything's going to be looking sweet. And yeah, do you want to take it away? What are you playing now, by the way?
Yeah, it's called...
Hon...
It's John Mueller, it's a drummer, and it's a record that's been released on Type Records, like, I don't know when exactly, maybe 3 years ago or something. It's a really, really nice record. It's like just a long soundscape of percussions and drums, like, it's pretty cool.
And what about running only this record for 90 minutes? Just that?
Can we just...
and sit down.
Do like proper lyric, where you just slow it down to like an absolute pause for 90 minutes, just spinning it.
All right, let's go. We're hearing you, man. Just ready for
we'll be touching in now and again to talk to you about the different records, having more of a kind of relaxed feel, but we'll let you get on with it. Low Jack and Torn Hawk in Paris. Here we go. Thanks.
So, LoJack, it's a special record for you, this one. We were talking about it before, like percussion record. Tell us about it.
It's something I discovered really recently, actually. I'm not sure about the pronunciation. It's like Julien Babinga and Kunku. But it's like a percussionist. It's a really old record from the 80s. That's Gwen Jamois, known by the name of UK. He's running a... And he just made me discover this amazing record. And there is actually another record from the same guy, and it's really a techno record, like a proto techno record with drum machines. Man, but this one is the first one. It's more like organic and. But yeah, definitely.
Actually, definitely sounds great.
To check.
Let's
amazing.
Hear it. You have other ones like that? Are we gonna have some more of this later?
Yeah, maybe.
Perfect.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Don't change. Thank you. Actually getting out of a big tunnel. Something massive just happened like a few tracks ago. This, what was this yellow record you just...
The yellow record,
definitely.
I mean, it's something I picked in an amazing record store in Rennes. It's in the west of France, in Bretagne.
Yeah.
And it's something called... I think it's called Gifluent. But I'm not...
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, you gotta buy it.
And yeah, I mean, it's... Something, it's almost concrete music, but it's made. I mean, it's kind of, you know, it's this guy is working with some cases that he built himself, and it's made like with you know, I don't know, like I would say, I don't know, like really like some really concrete stuff, like the like a sound of metals, like
okay,
on
like
a table,
recordings
and
of
it's
random,
really
shit.
Random, yeah.
Anyway,
yeah,
I get it.
Exactly.
Yeah. But the thing is, I mean, it's almost this record is amazing because it almost got a techno feel, you know, like it's really like really
exactly.
You can feel like the state of trance at some point, like it's really like really repetitive, like
so. I mean,
sick.
Yeah. I felt that we should, you know, stop on this record to avoid the track ID thing on the video. Gabriel, you got anything to say?
Oh yeah, I got loads to say. Like, firstly, the three deck mixing is sick. Secondly, when I saw Ambient Set, I was thinking it's going to be like New Age, like Brian Eno, Fax, like all the kind of... And immediately it just like... I should have known, obviously, it's you and your music. It's just crunching. We were saying like after 10 minutes, you were just like, fuck, put on beats. Like you had one ambient intro and then immediately it was just going into the grinding stuff. So it's cool. It's like the harsh ambient, like dark ambient kind of side of things.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Which is different, like, I guess. Because people think ambient is just like... You know, doing yoga and chilling out and shit, but this is like club.
You can do
ambient,
maybe you can do drugs on ambient too. Like, you know, I'm not saying that this is you have to do it, but
I think someone's having sex right now on this record. This is what's happening.
Yeah. Japanese dude.
Is it?
It was sent Japanese dude. I think.
Okay. Wow.
It's an old record from Japan, made in the 80s.
Yeah, let's get back to that.
Thanks. It's going fucking well so far, thank you.
Ah!
Ambient music.
Yeah, kind of.
Ambient music. That the last few tracks were anything but ambient music. That was like, could you just give a track ID for every single song you play today? Because we just have people being like, what's that track? What's that track? What's that track? But what are these two? Let's start there.
Just this one, this was like the soundscape, which is just like talk, and it's on the new Ron Morelli's release on Hospital Records.
Really, is it?
Yeah. And this one it's from my man The Wrecker. It's a remix he did on Desire really recently, and it's a special project from one of the former group of iCarb.
Yeah.
And I think it's the leader, and he recorded some tracks last year in Paris in Belleville. The record is called Belleville then, and yeah, there is this sick remix by The Wrecker, and love this dude.
It's all been so sick. I suppose as you're saying, like the kind of stuff that you're doing is not like weak ambient. It's like drone noise ambient. Like this kind of stuff is like not that ambient, but it's pretty like the kind of ambient that gives you like a headache, but like a pleasant, but not like a pleasant headache. And like as opposed to being like fall asleep lullaby music, it's like the kind of like fully like soundscape, like heavy crunching soundscape. It's cool. It's really sick. Thanks. No, it's really sick. I think you've got like 15, 20 minutes left.
Yeah.
So we'll touch in after you finish, before Torn Hawk will be on in a few minutes. But yeah, it's just been...
The Hawk.
Is he awake? Is he...
Yeah. He's waving.
He's ready. We'll see. We'll check back in a sec. It's been a joy. It's gone quickly as well. But yeah, we'll leave you for the last two or three. It's been great. Cheers.
Thank you.
Got the yellow vinyl. Thank you.
And this is it. Thank you, man.
Yeah, that was it, man. Thank you.
Everybody in the room, yo, make some noise. Okay, let's have a little sit on the couch, talk a little bit while our friend Tornhoek is getting ready.
Getting ready?
Yeah.
You say make some noise, by the way. I think he's just spent 94 minutes making some noise.
Yeah, exactly.
That was pretty sick. I think you two are going to lead a conversation in broken English and French.
Yeah, basically we're both French, but this is a global show, so, you know, let's go English, and, you know, by respect of you and everyone who speaks English. So this past track was a track of one of your friends, you just told me.
I mean, yeah, it's something that not really, I mean, it's an unreleased track. And it's definitely in my entourage, but it's not released yet.
Okay. Unreleased shit, man. Okay, whatever. Man, looks like you're in a great place right now. Like, you started it all with Get the Curse and In Paradisum, which is an awesome label, by the way. Like, really proud to have that in France. And now Lies. You know, you're chilling with Ron Morley, having some dog hearts with Tornhoek.
Oh yeah, big time, actually. Loving this shit. Heart of the animal, like the best part, actually.
Yeah, because I don't know if you guys got it, but yesterday those two guys, you know, went to the restaurant and had dog's hearts, which is awesome.
Yeah, dogs and lamb.
By the way.
Both.
Let's get back to your music, man. Yeah. So, we were just saying that you're in a great place right now. You're in a great label. What's the next step for you? I mean, you know, looks like you're getting to a new step every time. You know, Get the Curse, In Paradisum, Lies. Like, what's the next step, basically?
I'm gonna have a... I have a new EP scheduled. I hope it's gonna be released before the summer. It's on the Trilogy Tapes. It's a 6-track EP, a kind of a mini LP, and hopefully before the summer. Yeah.
All right. What kind of music is this gonna be?
Chill wave. No.
Chill wave. Yeah, I bet chill wave.
Yeah, I don't know. It's really. I mean, I mean, 6 tracks, and it's each track. It's something different. You know, it's like there is noise track. There is a. There is like a shoegaze track, maybe even a deep house track. I try to do something quite different than I'm usually do.
Okay, different style within the same thing.
Yeah.
Gabriel, you got something to add, maybe?
What I'm saying is what I like about your music and a lot of the music that your kind of friends and compatriots make is that it's like that very contrast between like having like rickety drum machines like 909s and 303s, but then having like ambient soundscapes and. There's no like boundaries. It's not like this is one thing. It's not pigeonholed. Everything merges so well together that if you brought out an EP with a noise track and a deep house track, it wouldn't feel wrong. It would feel right because it's really open and it's good. Like the whole scene at the moment is just so open-ended. No one knows where it can go. Like you could do a post-punk track or you could do, yeah, as you say, like an ambient track and it would just be fitting. And it's cool.
Yeah, I mean, it's always fun. Like, trying to have fun and trying different things on record after record. And yeah, it's all about that. And I couldn't really be stuck in just one genre, you know.
Sure.
But for me, it all makes sense, you know. I mean, it's not really. Some ambient Japanese noise from the 80s. It's really similar to a Christian Vogel record made in the 90s.
Yeah.
I think so. So yeah, I'm trying to link every record with each other because for me it's really the same music. You know?
Yeah.
In the same feel. Yeah.
How is it to feel like the guy, one of the few French guys who did 2 Boiler Rooms in their lives? Because it's actually your second one.
It's a gift.
Yeah, you played Social Club the other day, a few months ago.
Yeah.
That was way more dance floor. Different vibes, right?
Yeah, way more dance floor, yeah, because that was in a club, and that was really like, that was really supposed to be very club-oriented.
So how's going to be your third Boiler Room, like in a few months?
I'm going to jungle, maybe.